Having covered how machines communicate across a local area network, we now turn our attention to how they communicate across the internet and the network layer of our hierarchy. Whereas other layers use a variety of technologies and protocols, the network layer really only uses IP, which is short for Internet Protocol. Every machine on the internet proper gets a unique 32-bit address, which is usually written out as four decimal numbers between 0 and 255. So, for example, 72.14.248.239 is currently the IP address for Udacity's homepage. Ranges of addresses are allocated by regional internet registries, all of which are under control of IANA, the International Assigned Numbers Authority. The ranges themselves are commonly specified by a 32-bit IP, followed by a slash, and then the number of bits understood to specify the network ID. This is referred to as CIDR notation. The first number of these bits of the 32 specify the range, and then the rightmost bits specify the particular host. For example, MIT was allocated long ago the range 18.0.0.0/8, meaning that any IP starting with 18 belongs to MIT. There are about 2 to the 24th of them. Georgia Tech has the range 130.207.0.0/16, meaning that any IP starting with 130.207 belongs to Georgia Tech. There are about 2 to the 16th of those because there are 16 unspecified bits in this range. At the time of this recording, a New Jersey company called Linode has been allocated the address range 50.16.48.0/20. So this gives them 12 bits of host and the range 50.116.48.0 to 50.16.63.255. Again, about 2 to the 12th IPs. IPs have become a precious commodity these days, as most all of them have been allocated, and not very efficiently. For instance, tech-savvy as they are, MIT is probably not using all 2 to the 24th or 16 million of its addresses. One solution to this problem is simply to expand the address space to use more bits. The new internet protocol called IPv6, the old one is called IPv4, uses 128-bit IP addresses. The problem is that IPv4 is so universal and so many other systems depend on it that adoption of the new protocol has been slow. I encourage you to read more about this on your own.